and welcome to Lesmin's channel. My name is Gintare, and today we are going to talk about everything you need to know before sculpting with clay.
Work setup. What concerns the workplace, I personally usually work on the kitchen floor, or sometimes I work at the table. My boyfriend loves to sculpt standing up at the balcony because he likes the brightness of the sun. It's just a matter of preference really, and also what your body feels most comfortable in. But whatever you choose, make sure that the working surface is clean, because otherwise those little particles might get caught up in the clay and they do make the job a pain in the sometimes. Many people don't need a special place to do the sculpting, but if you want to invest in your workspace, chances are you will thank yourself later. Only thing that can stop you is, no, not your imagination, only the size of your wallet. When it comes to lighting in the room, I prefer to work in a medium lit area. I noticed if it's too bright or too dark, my eyes get tired faster. But it's just me. For other people, I do recommend getting a lot of lamps around the workspace so you can adjust the brightness by turning them off and on, or you can buy a ring light that have a dim light function. Usually I use midday light to do my sculpting things. It works the best and is very cheap as well. To sum up, if you don't have resources, you just have to have windows at home. But in case you are a serial killer and you want your windows covered at all times, just use any lamps that you have.
And now is the time when you can subscribe to my channel and hit that like button over there.
Things that are great to have. Tools. I got all of mine from eBay or AliExpress. I'm a firm believer in great tools, but also they shouldn't break your bank. And let me say, those that I bought almost all perform wonderfully. The price of any single tool I own ranges from 90 cents to 3 euros. Naturally, the pack of metal tools will be a bit more expensive than wooden ones. Quality clay is another great thing to have. Simple clay that dries out in the air is not good for sculpting, at least for the beginners, because it dries out too fast and starts to crack, so you have to work really quick with it. It's a matter of minutes, but your project can take days, even weeks. For the mold making, masks, and or if you want to make multiples of something, the best clay I found would be monster clay in medium. I will not go too into detail for now because I have an in-depth video coming about various clay soon. Stay tuned for that. In short, it is extremely reusable clay and you can buy a sample size of it to try out for as small as $5.95 for 113 grams. If you like doing one-of-a-kind figurines, just grab Sculpey clay. It looks like flesh right from the get-go, and if you bake it, it hardens and becomes a tiny stone sculpture. You will probably be able to do several sculptures off of one box as well, because it contains 454 grams for $15.99. So one figurine you'll make will cost about $5 to $6 to make. It's not very cheap, but the effect of finished work is amazing. Another great thing to have is the reference of your chosen creature anatomy. For example, I wanted to make steampunk elves, so I used Skyrim's Falmer as a reference. And in addition, in some places I used human skull anatomy as well to know where the eyes, cheeks, and temple should be. Why do you need that? Well, it simply makes the whole monster more believable to a human eye. To us, it looks like it could be real. What I use is some human anatomy book
Anatomia Человека
that I stole from my mom when I was moving out, because I was always fascinated by human anatomy. 6 years later, today, I can proudly say that this is one of my best steals of life, and needless to say that I don't understand what is written in the book, but the pictures look gorgeous. And to be fair, pictures is all you need. Also, other books that might be useful, bird books for the times you want to make bird person, bug books for when you feel like you want to make an insect hybrid, sloth books if you want to make sloths, and so on and so forth. I will leave some links down below of great books. However, if you have no intention or resources to purchase books, you can just Google the anatomy of whatever and use it as your guide as well.
I hope this video was somehow helpful, and if you have something to add, please do that in the comment section below. All of the links will be listed down below, as well as my Patreon. Thank you so much for watching, and if you like, consider subscribing and maybe press that like button down below, and see you in my next video about how to make face casts.